The Aquino administration's grant of livelihood assistance to communities identified with the PMP-RPAABB is being criticized by some lawmakers. Alliance of Concerned Teachers Party List Representative Antonio Tino is among those who are against the plan. He calls the splinter group no more than a private armed group. Congressman Tino joins us on Hot Copy. Good day to you, Congressman.
Good day.
Okay, now why are you against the government giving 31 million pesos to the RPAABB?
Well, several reasons. First of all, the group itself, no, and its track record.
Okay.
We've received reports, for instance, that since signing the peace agreement in 2000,
yes,
it's no longer actually actively fighting the government.
Okay.
In fact, they've been acting as a sort of private army for certain local politicians.
Are you serious?
In Negros,
really?
That's one report we've received. And also, we've received reports that they've been identified as harassing, burning,
yeah,
strafing,
yeah,
farmers.
Oh, but confirmed.
Engaged in tinatawag nilang kampuhan. The landless farmers in Negros, they have a campaign where they occupy hacienda lands.
Okay.
And instead of farming sugarcane, instead of planting sugarcane, they plant rice, palay, vegetables for their own consumption. And they've been victimized by violence from the RPAABB, acting in behalf of landlords.
Okay. No? All right. Now, Congressman, dapat balikan natin ang kasaysayan nito. Mm-hmm. Ang planong pagbibigay ng pera sa ABB ay nung administrasyon ni dating Pangulong Estrada. Okay, then start from there.
Well, importante yung context na yun. No? The peace agreement, the initial agreement was signed in December 2000. At that time, kainitan yun ng impeachment trial ni ERAP. No? And I think the Estrada administration was looking for a dramatic signing with some
a rebel group
to shore up its hold on power.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, the RPAABB was not significant enough to boost his hold on power.
Uh-oh.
And by January, he was ousted.
Okay.
Know?
And ERAP said that hindi na daw sila nag-release ng pera nung pinagpatuloy ng ABB yung pangingid na.
Well, I don't know, because the agreement was signed in December and he was out by January. But, you know, kailangan nga balikan tong agreement na to kasi doon nakalagay na bibigyan sila ng 500 million pesos.
Uh-uh.
So, you have to review that. You know, you're talking about a relatively small force. By their own admission, they're,
yes,
around 300.
That's half a billion pesos.
Yeah, and concentrated in mainly in Negros and some parts of Iloilo.
Yeah.
Tapos nilaan na ng 500 million pesos. And according to reports, government is claiming that they've already disbursed around 300 million. No? Tapos in projects.
Mm-mm.
Tapos meron pang, aside from a 10 million initial release, tapos meron pang ang 31 million for at least 31 million for 2012. Tapos ang ito, actually ang kine-question talaga namin dito yung PAMANA program.
Okay.
Which is a part of the counter-insurgency program of government. PAMANA, Payapa at Masaganang Pamayanan.
Okay.
So for the 2012 budget, merong 1.9 billion na naka-allocate dito sa PAMANA. Several agencies will implement it. OPAP, the DILG, the SWD, and DAR. No? So merong 329 million sa Office of the Presidential Advisor on the Peace Process.
But it's for only the ABB?
It's not just for the ABB. It's
okay.
For yung 329 million nila is for 970 barangays in conflict areas daw, including areas where supposedly there is a RPAABB presence.
Okay.
Ang porma nito is it's like a cash grant. It's kind of like a CCT pa rin, no? So bibigyan ng 350,000 pesos yung barangay na na-identify as conflict affected.
Na may ABB.
Well, in this case, na may ABB. Tapos, it's supposedly for livelihood projects.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, OPAP has a bad track record when it comes to disbursing these funds supposedly for counterinsurgency, okay, or for dati, no, nung panahon ni General Esperon.
Uh-oh.
He became one of the heads of OPAP.
Uh-oh.
Meron pang 170 million,
okay,
of ang tawag nila doon social integration program noon. No, 170 million hindi pa accounted for,
okay,
hanggang ngayon. No, so we're concerned that given this track record, hindi pa nare-resolve to, bibigyan na naman ng 329 million pesos ang
OPAP. How does the OPAP give the money? Do they give it in cash? Like for example, I mean, it was allegedly it was the OPAP's suggestion to Pinoy, mm-hmm, to give the MILF 5 billion and it was given via check. Mm-hmm. Was it check or cash? Something like that.
Well, for this pamana, according to the explanation of OPAP, dadaan daw nila sa LGU.
Sa mayor?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
But this one of the concerns we raised during the budget deliberations in the House was yung capacity ng OPAP. Sa kanila binigay yung 329 million of this pamana. What's their capacity to implement such a program? They, yeah, don't even have the personnel. No?
Okay.
Chinek namin yung staffing ng OPAP. And what we learned, to our shock, was wala pala itong permanent personnel.
Yeah.
No, puro contractuals, mga 300 plus contractuals,
oh,
lang.
Gosh.
So, given that,
yeah,
we're really concerned about their capacity to monitor,
uh-oh,
to implement. Magbibigay sila ng pera.
Uh-oh.
How do we know na maayos na ma-implement ito?
But more than that, are they equipped in, for example, developing social community transformation, which NGOs are good at? Yeah, do they do that?
Exactly. Exactly. Yun nga. When we say capacity, including the capacity of their personnel to implement development projects.
Yeah, community transformation.
In DSWD, they clearly have the experience and the training, the technology to do that, or not the OPAP.
Or a group that I work with, World Vision, that's what they do. Mm-hmm. That's all they do, community transformation.
Kaya nga in the past, I go back to the track record of OPAP, naging parang gatasan yung supposedly counterinsurgency funds or peace funds, reintegration funds.
Yeah.
Naging gatasan ng mga allegedly ng mga opisyal ng military at kung sino-sino pa.
Okay. So if 31 million is to be released to the ABB, how much was released prior to the 31 million?
Well, according to a report of the OPAP, something like over 300 million na raw ang nare-release.
During the
bulk
time
of it, during the Arroyo administration.
Now, okay, the 300 million released during the Arroyo administration, it was not audited or accounted for?
Well, I don't know specifically about the 300 million.
Yeah.
What I know is during the time of Esperon, 170 million
is not accounted
OPAP
for.
Funds were not accounted for.
No. Okay. Kasi are they given to the rebel directly? Like for example, when it's development in a town. Mm-hmm. I mean, how do they do it? Does the rebel surrender the gun? How do you know what I mean? What is the ano ang method?
Well, it's better for OPAP itself to explain the mechanics of this PAMANA program, no? But according to the explanations they gave us during the budget hearings, now, they've identified over 900 barangays, including the barangays in the Visayas, where the RPA are present.
Okay.
And as I said, they will release 350,000 pesos through the LGU for livelihood projects.
Okay. All right. Now, we're trying to get the side of Presidential Advisor on Peace Process, Ging Deles, but she's in a closed-door meeting. But let me read something that she had said in a couple of interviews that you can react to. She said, "This is not a political settlement. This is part of the closure process, including the final disposition of forces and arms with development and livelihood from PAMANA. We don't want to pass on another unfinished business to the next administration."
Well, yun nga hindi natin maintindihan. Sinasabi, it's not a political settlement. What is needed if you really want to address the roots of insurgency is a political settlement.
Okay.
No? Kaya nga ang concern natin, no, they're pouring these resources into RPA ABB. Mm-hmm. Meanwhile, the talks between the MILF and the CPP, NPA, NDF, they're stalled.
Yeah.
No? If you really want to come to grips
they're
with the question of peace in our country, ito yung dalawang dapat na kausapin.
Okay. All right. You said that's very good, MILF and CPP, NPA. Mm-hmm. Now, is the government doing the right thing by giving goodwill money? Because Pinoy himself gave 5 million to the MILF. Do you agree with that? Of the people's money.
Mm-hmm. Well, if it's you know, if it's part of commitments during previous agreements,
no,
then
this recent one.
Well, there are many ways to show goodwill, no? Ang pinaka-importante sundin yung mga dating na pagkasunduan.
Okay.
For instance, in the case of the CPP, the peace talks with the CPP, ngayon ang stall dito yung release of a certain number of political prisoners who are supposedly covered by the JASIG, yung the agreement on immunity.
Okay.
So ito hindi kailangan ng pera.
Mm-mm.
na hindi kailangan maglabas ng pera ng Pinoy administration,
yeah,
ngunit hindi sinusunod
ng Pinoy administration.
Ng Pinoy administration. Kaya there was supposed to be some talks in late October in Oslo, pero hindi ito natuloy because as far as the CPP, NPA, NDF was concerned, the Aquino administration did not fulfill its obligations.
Okay. All right. Mm-hmm. Now, with the MILF, we'll just veer slightly. Mm-hmm. With the MILF now saying they will not surrender Asnawi, who is a lawless element but clearly a member of the MILF, because now they're saying they won't surrender him. What's your take on that?
Well, again, we have to go back to the context of their agreements. Maraming napag-usapan yan. They're including mechanisms on how to settle conflicts like this.
Okay.
So they have to go back to talks, no?
Mm-mm.
And I think it would be counterproductive to just go in and use force on the part of government. So you know, now is a good time to open, talks.
All right. So one, you feel that the money being given to ABB is too big for the number of the group?
Well, just looking at the agreement, a commitment of 500 million pesos for a, you know, relatively small force concentrated in a, you know.
You could have invested it in Mindanao na lang, no?
Yeah, exactly. 500 million pesos for the whole region would be significant, no, in terms of development.
Yeah.
So, kaya nga kailangan balikan yung context, no, nung era Estrada administration.
Yeah.
No, parang may pagka midnight deal yung katangian ng peace agreement na ito.
Okay. It says here that the accord that was signed in December 2000, this is according to, of course, Gingdeles, consists of the following components. Number one, declaration of cessation of hostilities. Number two, release of political prisoners and their assistance through the reintegration fund. Number three, implementation of development projects. And number four, policy reforms.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just curious, the ABB has the...
Well, I think the most important there is policy reforms. I mean, we've heard nothing at all about any policy reforms to be implemented by the government to address the concerns of those who are taking up arms against the government. No?
Okay.
So parang lumalabas, livelihood lang ang tugon ng gobyerno dito.
Uh-oh.
Ngayon, livelihood projects lang ba ang kailangan para matigil na ang armadong pag-aalsa ng mga mamamayan? Hindi, no? Kailangan, why is there armed conflict in our country? It's because of deep-rooted socio-economic problems, no?
Yung
sa kanayunan, it mainly has to do with land, no? The lack of genuine land reform. So hindi ito yung halimbawa, ito yung agenda sa peace talks, the stalled peace talks between the CPP, NPA, NDF and the Philippine government. yung talks on social and economic reforms.
Okay. Now, is it unconstitutional or illegal in any way for the president to give funding to rebel groups?
There are precedents. Parang if I remember correctly, there were commitments of funds to the MNLF when they signed a peace agreement.
Yeah.
With at the time administration ni President Ramos.
No? When there's an agreement, it's it's constitutional, it's legal.
I suppose so. Yeah. And
but what about the president giving a check to the MILF?
Well, kailangan siguro pag-aralan kung ano yung diretsyong binigay sa organisasyon or usually dinadaan sa mga programa yan eh, no? Ng gobyerno. Mm-mm. So, pero kailangan suriin natin kung ano talaga yung mga patakaran dyan.
Okay. Alright, we'll take a quick break. When we return, our guest, Congressman Antonio Tino, will answer questions from our viewers. Hot Copy will be right back.